Passport 2520RL here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. 4,850 pounds, only 4,850. We get a couples camper with a fifth wheel shower in it, power awning, full 80-inch queen bed, enclosed heated underbelly, easy adjust awning, big pass-through front storage. Everything that matters and nothing that doesn't. That is who Passport is. There's a lot of lightweights on the market, guys, but in their market, if you see a Passport competing there, they're pretty much one of the top dogs. They're the number one lightweight at Keystone, have been for ages now, and they just continue to get a little bit better every single year. What I like about them, though, is they make smart decisions and intelligent updates, things that they don't let affect the price tag, so they have been kind of immune to price creep. Like, you see that big front pass-through storage compartment there, that's key. Like I said, the underbelly is enclosed. It is insulated with their extra thick laminated floor. You know, the walls, the floor, all aluminum framed and laminated. Well, the whole thing's aluminum framed. The entire roof skeleton has like 12-inch on-center roof trusses. There's a lot of meat inside of this skeleton that keeps it held together. They use a different style frame on here. They have an NXG frame on this that is like an aircraft style frame. It is lighter and stronger. It's actually a big chunk of the money invested in this RV, but your chassis is the foundation if you imagine a house. That's the most critical component on this RV, so they invest money there. Quick mention of the black tank flush system, the outside utility shower. We have wide stance to build axles that prevents the RV from porpoising as hard down the road. It's just going to kind of rock real easy, and you're not going to get chucked around your vehicle. All windows are UV tinted. I point that out because not every price focused ultralight or trailer is going to be that way. All windows also open for ventilation. This has a nice, bright, very comfortably, naturally illuminated interior because it has all these big windows. Every Passport period has some form of outside cook station. This one has a full-on bumper-mounted RVQ grill. If it was a Passport with an outside kitchen, then it would actually have a little cooktop built right in. So no matter what, you've always got an outside cook method here. Now, what's cool is these aren't just nice power awnings. They do have full LED lights at the base of them, and they're easy adjust. That's all it takes to put a pitch adjustment on this awning. You saw it in real time, folks. There's no smoke and mirrors going on here. What's really cool is you can actually leave that awning arm bent down like that and still retract the awning and not mess anything up. Lipper, who put this together, did an excellent job of that. And when you're done with it, you just push it right back up like that. It's literally a two-finger adjustment awning. That's all the harder this is. Well, fun trick, what you do is you put the kids chair over here, and you pull that down and you dump the water on them and you run away cackling. There's a lot of good storage inside, but they had a big corner with just a ton of countertop space. They had a pocket that was hard to get to, so instead they encapsulated it inside where it was tough to get to and opened it outside, because there is no such thing as too much outside storage or inside or anywhere. This just makes it easy to get to. Nice little power outlets right there, so that you can, if you want a little mini fridge or TV station or anything out here, you can do that. We of course have outside speakers for your outdoor entertainment. And another thing, a lot of budget-focused trailers are going to have double steps. We still have triple steps here. We still have an oversized entry handle. And all this stuff I'm telling you about, guys, is standard. Passports are, they're cookie cutter. They're all basically built the same. You just have a little choice of fabrics. And that's about the only thing you can really do to them. There's not really even a lot of options available on these. And that is there for quality and consistency standpoint. The same guy builds a Passport the same way every time, and then you don't have problems. Right when you walk in the door, you've got a handy command center down here for your power awning and lights and all that. All your ceiling lights are just on one handy switch. Oh, what is this called? I think that's called Rattan or something like that. But it's like spelled Rattan. It's just not a good spelling. Anyway. That's the color scheme that we're looking at. So if you like everything else except that more browner tone color scheme, I'm gonna get this TV out of the way. This has a big swing arm on the TV, but as you can see, it can get in your way too if you're just walking in. Big U-dinette here, and that's where this starts to separate itself from similar models within the marketplace. Passports are lighter. Passports have proven themselves to be shockingly reliable, and instead of just a two-bench dinette, they went with a full-size U-dinette here. There actually is such a thing as a small U-dinette that you can't sit people at as easily. This is a full-size one. You can easily still sit four people here and have room for two chairs on the other side. Full storage all the way under. Now, the biggest benefit, though, to a U-dinette beyond a little more storage is a bigger sleeping space than a common two-bench dinette can possibly have. And you have, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 big windows in this living room and a ceiling vent here in the kitchen for extra light, extra airflow. And remember, these are all max airflow ventilating windows with nightshades for privacy. So this is a little jackknife sofa that can fold down into an extra sleeper. It kind of looks a little bit like a theater seat because I moved that extra armrest over because I wanted folks to be able to see the perfect little phone storage pocket that they have going on here. And you notice that they're very generous with outlets so that you've always got charging outlets here and there. And if you notice real quick, this is not a light trick. This wall is darker and accented as compared to that one. A nice little residential touch to help it feel a little bit deeper and open. Now, a lot of rear living room trailers have poor storage, but what's funny is this 25-foot rear living has about the same storage capacity as a lot of these 29-foot rear livings. They just did a really good job. This is an awesome floor plan. And holy crap counter space, Batman. Excellent counter space, and we do have outlets mounted under the cabinets with additional spotlighting as well that I don't even need to turn on. They use a 60-40 split on the sink. And if you don't know why that's there, you're going to look at it and say, well, that's dumb. A lot of people in smaller campers will go primitive or dry or boondock camping, whatever your word for it is. When you're doing that, you don't want to use any more fresh water than you have to out of your tank. So they have one smaller sink basin for that sort of situation. If you're park camping, ta-da! We have a big sink. So you kind of get the best of both worlds here. And again, you've got just all the room in the world for appliances like coffee makers and griddles and everything over here. You have you do have drawers. You do have decent pots and pan storage for a small camper. Like I said, central air, central heat, LED lighting. Everything that matters, nothing that doesn't. That's the cool thing about these. You know, if you, not everybody wants to drive a big truck. Some people just want a decent mid-sized SUV. That's who this is made for. If you got a tow package equipped SUV and it's just the two of you, this one right here is your camper. All-in-one AM, FM, CD, DVD, Bluetooth, so you do not need to lug along extra electronics. And again, there is no bad seat in the house because even if you're sitting in the corner of this dinette, you can still get a bead on the TV. Another reason I like to put these videos together is there are things in this trailer that aren't easily photoed, and this closet right here next to the entry door is one of them. It can be a closet, a pantry, a linen cabinet, or any combination thereof because these shelves right here adjust. Another question I get a lot of times is, what's that? That's like, think of it, that's called your converter, but think of it like your fuse box in your house, kind of like that. Now, they put another big closet cabinet linen section, whatever you want it to be, over here. So you have all kinds of good storage capacity going on in this little trailer. The bathroom, I like how this is right next to the entry door. Walk in, use the bathroom, walk out. Plus, the refrigerator is also just a step away, so you're never tracking dirt through your trailer. A lot of people will only buy trailers if it has a direct access bathroom door just because of how much dirt it cuts down on in your camper. This basically has the same thing. But here we're getting a nice fifth wheel type shower. It does have full shower wall surround enclosures to keep it protected. We do have a little bit of space down here. They went ahead and left the plumbing open. It may not be the prettiest thing to look at, but you know what? At least you can still maybe shove some of your toilet paper and stuff in there. Some storage is better than none. And a medicine cabinet in a class that often at this price point just has mirrors on the wall. It actually gives you a place to keep your toothbrush and toothpaste tucked away. Nice touches like that. I mentioned briefly outside, but I'll mention again, we do have a true 80-inch queen bed here, which is a best-in-class feature. There are a few other lightweights with true 80-inch queen beds. I'm not aware of any others that match the price point of a Passport with a full queen bed. There are power outlets for CPAP machines and whatnot. They have them mounted down here in the base of the bed. You can throw machines or phone chargers or anything you want up there. We've got our normal his and hers wardrobes. We do have a sliding pocket privacy door here. And once again, everything that matters, nothing you don't, that doesn't, and you're not paying for all the extra jazz. There's snazzy trailers out there, don't get me wrong. There's some very, very sharp trailers out there. But how much more money are you going to pay to really just replicate all the same critical stuff that's already present in the Passport? That's kind of the question. And that is why they have proven themselves to just be a monster in the market. And thankfully, they're just not a brand that we have to work on a lot, you know? I don't know that there's any such thing as a perfect trailer, but this is going to come as close as you can get. And for something that more people can afford, you know. So give us a call, learn a little bit more. Again, there's a lot of nice trailers out there, but this one hits all the high points and just doesn't worry about the stuff that is more preferential. It's got all the needs covered. Everything you need, nothing you don't. 800-256-5196. Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Take care. Stay safe. Happy camping, everybody.